embryo of dicot seeds. Materials required: distilled water and red kidney beans, gram, seeds of peas, needle, brush, forceps, and dissecting microscope. Pea seed. Procedure: place a few pea seeds in a beaker containing distilled water. Soak the pea seeds overnight. Using a pair of forceps, pick one seed from the beaker and place it in a watch glass. Remove the seed coat of the pea seed using the forceps and needle. Using the forceps, pick up the seed and place it on the stage of the dissection microscope. Separate the two cotyledons of the pea seed using the forceps and needle. Observe the seed through the lens of the dissection microscope. Observations: pea seeds are round in shape. One end of the embryonic axis lies enclosed between the two cotyledons and is called the plumule. The plumule develops into a shoot. We can see a hypocotyl on each seed, which is located above the root and below the stalk of the cotyledon. The other end of the embryonic axis protrudes outside the cotyledons and is called the radicle. The radicle develops into the root. The pea seed contains two thick, fleshy cotyledons that are food storage organs. Since two cotyledons are in the pea seed, it is a dicot seed. Gram seed. Procedure: place a few gram seeds in a beaker containing distilled water. Soak the gram seeds overnight. Using a pair of forceps, pick one seed from the beaker and place it in a watch glass. Remove the seed coat of the gram seed using the forceps and needle. Using the forceps, pick up the seed and place it on the stage of the dissecting microscope. Separate the two cotyledons of the gram seed using the forceps and needle. Observe the seed through the lens of the dissection microscope. Observations: gram seeds are round in shape. The scar seen along the notch of the gram seed is called the hilum. It is through the hilum that the seed is attached to the inner margin of the fruit. The seed imbibes water through the microphyll seen at the end of the hilum. The gram seed contains two thick, fleshy cotyledons that are food storage organs. We can observe a plumule on the gram seed, which gives rise to the first true leaves. The radicle is the embryonic root inside the seed, which grows downward into the soil. Above the radicle, we can see an embryonic stem or hypocotyl. Since two cotyledons are seen in the gram seeds are dicot seeds. Red kidney bean. Procedure: place a few seeds of red kidney bean in a beaker containing distilled water. Soak the seeds overnight. Using a pair of forceps, pick one seed from the beaker and place it in a watch glass. Remove the seed coat of the bean seed using the forceps and needle. Using the forceps, pick up the seed and place it on the stage of the dissection microscope. Separate the two cotyledons of the seed using the forceps and needle. Observe the seed through the lens of the dissection microscope. Observations: kidney beans are shaped like a kidney. The scar seen along the notch of the kidney bean is the hilum. The small pore called microphyll is located at one end of the hilum, through which the seed imbibes water. The kidney bean seed contains two thick, fleshy cotyledons that are food storage organs. One end of the embryonic axis lies enclosed between the two cotyledons and is called plumule, which develops into a shoot. The embryonic stem that can be seen is the hypocotyl. The other end of the embryonic axis protrudes outside the cotyledons and is called the radicle. This develops into the root. Since two cotyledons are seen in the kidney bean seed, it is a dicot seed.